I have to say this. And I don't want you to think I was prying or anything, but... Well, I'd never come across them if I hadn't been tidying up the dirt and the filth that you left after yourself. But I come across a certain kind of literature, I suppose you could call it. Literature. It isn't what I would call it. That stuff you have back there in the closet. I just happened to see it as I was hanging up your jacket. It's completely your own business what you read. But I don't think I don't believe we've had anything like that in the house before. And I wouldn't like to think that the people who stay here read that kind of thing on a regular basis. Well, now I know you're a young man, you've got other interests. But I think that that's trash. I mean, that's what I think. I think it is just trash and filth. You probably think I'm very old-fashioned, very nosy Parker. But I probably am. But what I want to say is, I've seen a lot of the world. I've lived. I've seen people come and go in this house here over the years. Now, you tell me what would persuade anybody to pose for those pictures. I mean, what would persuade a woman to just show herself like that? Can't imagine. I just cannot imagine. I like you, you know. I think you're a very nice young man. I watch you going in and out, and I think to myself, he looks like he should have somebody to care for him. Looks like he should have... Like he mightn't be well. Then when I come across these magazines, well... I sure think that's no way for him to be treating himself. And that you probably... Well, you probably don't have too much in your life if you have to resort to those. But I don't know what you use them for. But you're keeping them a secret if you're keeping them in that box here. Like you must be ashamed of them somehow. There's no harm in having secrets. Sure, we all have secrets. You write down some of yours too, don't you? I know, because I come across your journal here. Well, and I would never have looked at it, but I was dusting. Oh, you've got nice handwriting. That's what caught my eye. I was looking at your handwriting. And then I saw what you wrote. It's no shame to write your secrets down. I have thoughts like that myself. The things that you were writing about. We all have those kind of thoughts. You know, I was reading for quite a while before I realized that it was myself you were writing about. Oh, well, I wanted to close up immediately then, but You know, I was curious to see if we'd any, I suppose, thoughts in common. I didn't know you were watching me so much. Strange. To have somebody looking at you like that, writing it all down. And you, writing as if you could see right through my blouse. Old boots, aren't you, eh? It's only fair that I should read what you've written about the two of us. What we do when we're together. Well, in your mind, that is. We're sort of partners, I suppose you could say. It's strange, too, you know, because sometimes at night, when I'm just thinking my own thoughts and it's late, well, I know you're still up because I can see the light from your window cast in the garden outside. I sometimes have thoughts like that myself. I think about you. I even got up once. I just came out on the landing and stood there, listened at your door. But I turned and came back in my own room. Strange place, isn't it? Strange, lonely place. Sometimes you meet someone on the stairs, look them right in the eye. All the world passes between you. And sometimes that's the person you should be with. It was very difficult to say so. Sometimes when I look at you, I think I could stretch out my arms to you. I could just put my fingers just there. I could. I could give you something that you need, I think. And I could find something in you that I need to. You'd like that, wouldn't you? I mean, I know, because I read it in your diary there. You know, I see you going up and down the stairs. You're so discreet. Never letting on anything. But I know what you really feel now. You know, you pass close to me. The other morning, got a whiff of your skin. Look. My hands. I'm shivering now.